Welcome to the TRCA Brock Lands. These lands were acquired in 2011 by Toronto Region Conservation Authority. They are former City of Toronto landfill sites and collectively known as the Brock Lands. The property is 392 hectares and adjacent to two major natural corridors. Together, they offer critical wildlife habitat and connectivity to other habitat in Duffins Creek watershed. Today, I'm on the Brock Site 7, located southeast of Sideline 7 and Highway 7. This site has undergone terrestrial tree planting and shrub plantings for a couple of years now, following wetland and stream restoration projects in 2014 and 2016, but there is still more room for plants. The plantings have been to support the restoration of habitat within the Brock Lands in Durham region. This overall restoration goal is to protect and maximize the contribution of the Brocklands to the wider natural system. With this in mind, TRCA applied for the federal EcoAction Community Funding Program. This funding will help us engage residents, especially youth, in action-based events to help protect, enhance, and restore natural infrastructure and create more sustainable communities. Duffins Creek watershed has the highest forest cover in our region at 27% cover. This is substantial. However, we always want to strive for more to help improve our natural systems. Restoration activities will focus on planting indigenous vegetation, including trees, shrubs, wildflowers, and aquatic plants as appropriate. Plantings will help achieve the ecological restoration goals of improving stream form, water quality, and flood management, as well as increasing natural coverage and improving habitat quality. Plantings will improve connectivity to nearby habitats and improve habitat quality. The larger the habitat block, the more resilient the associated flora and fauna communities are to developments within the landscape and to increased user pressure. The Brock North site is ideally situated to protect and enhance the aquatic integrity of sensitive habitats within Duffins Creek's watershed. These lands contain the confluences of two sensitive watercourses, Brome Creek, a true cold water stream, and Spring Creek, a cool water stream. Brome Creek contains sensitive salmonoid species such as brook trout. These fish require cold, clean water and often spawn directly over locations of groundwater upwelling. By planting shrubs near and along the streams, water quality will be improved. Riparian plantings will cast shade over the watercourse, lowering the water temperature and increasing habitat for sensitive fish species. We were successful in receiving 2 years of EcoAction funding to help with this project. We will be delivering 74 greening events where participants will actively learn about the restoration projects they are contributing to and plant 8,000 indigenous trees, shrubs, wildflowers, and aquatic plants. We will be actively engaging 2,680 participants in restoration activities. This project will engage a variety of audiences, including youth, school groups, and community groups such as scouts, guides, and faith organizations, as well as families. The Trans-Canada Trail runs along the east side of the property, which takes you along Duffins Creek and into Greenwood Conservation Area. It is an enjoyable way to experience the site by yourself. However, we would ask that you be mindful and careful when hiking through the property and always stay on trail. You can also help to monitor and track the species on the site through community science. As you're attending our events or hiking the trails, we encourage you to record or take pictures of different plants and animals and submit them to iNaturalist. This is a great way to contribute to a larger project and get to know the flora and fauna in the area. If you're interested in helping with our youth greening project, visit our event calendar at www.trca.ca. We always need people to help with tree plantings at the site and around the GTA.